What's up, everybody? Welcome to SmackDown Live, and we're coming at you from Greensboro, North Carolina. And it's sure to be a great show tonight.
It's going to be. It's SmackDown. We've been through this.
All right, Tyler, calm down. You don't need to be so hostile as soon as the show starts.
I'm not being hostile.
But tonight, our opening matchup, we'll see Rich Swann and Cedric Alexander, high energy, taking on Shane Thorne and Nick Miller, TM61.
It is pronounced Luck and Fluke.
Oh, okay.
That's how they won the tag team titles.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That's true. But, speaking of titles.
Yeah?
We have, big announcement right now, we have the Intercontinental Championship on the line tonight. Hideo Itami, if you remember last week in that 8-man tag team match, he never got a chance to be in the ring. So what did he do? He demanded a match with Roderick Strong, and he wanted the Intercontinental Championship on the line. Roderick Strong, being a strong champion, a true champion, he had no problem putting the title on the line. So what better way to show that SmackDown is better than Raw than with our first televised championship match?
I don't know.
Exactly.
But after that, we've got Tyson Kidd taking on Darren Young.
That's right, Tyson Kidd. He wants to climb up that mountain again. He wants to prove himself. He hasn't been relevant for a while, but he wants to get there, and I guess the same with Darren Young, whatever.
Well, nice of you to talk up Tyson Kidd that way and just kind of throw Darren Young out to the wind.
I'm just saying.
Well, after that, we've got Goldust taking on Curtis Axel.
Oh.
And Curtis Axel, of course, with his new attitude lately.
Did Goldust happen to see the match last week with Ty Dillinger? I don't think he did.
Probably not.
Ty may have walked out the winner, but at what cost? Curtis Axel just destroying him,
very,
not caring.
Very, very true. And we'll see if Goldust can, defend himself, leave in one piece even, against Curtis Axel here tonight.
Or will he be one big shattered dream?
I don't know. I guess we'll have to find out. But after that, we've got Ember Moon taking on Tamina in a televised women's match.
Well, obviously it's televised. Anyway, Ember Moon pretty much being cost of the SmackDown Women's Championship at Payback. The whole alliance with Emma and Peyton Royce and Billie Kay, who knows, but Ember Moon wants to prove that she deserves another chance at that Women's Championship.
I mean, let's be frank. She got screwed out of it, I'd say.
We still don't know what's going on. We know the three of them, Emma, Peyton, Billy, they formed their own Aussie posse. They want to take over SmackDown. They want to take over the women's division.
And we'll have to see what comes out of this match. Ember Moon, probably not in the greatest mood, so we'll see what happens.
Probably not.
But then we have our main event. We've got a tag team action coming up. We've got Seth Rollins and Dean Ambrose taking on Baron Corbin, your WWE champion, and Chris Jericho.
Best in the world, might I add. Dean Ambrose just losing his mind last week, just viciously attacking Baron Corbin. Three dirty deeds.
Three dirty deeds.
I'm surprised Baron Corbin doesn't have a concussion by now.
You're not wrong.
I'm always right.
I wouldn't say that.
I'm just saying.
There's proof of you being wrong.
We need to get started.
Well, let's get into our first matchup here tonight. High energy taking on TM61.
We'll be right back.
Alrighty, guys, getting into the matchup here, we've got High Energy, Cedric Alexander and Rich Swann taking on TM61.
Oh.
Shane Thorne and Nick Miller, excuse me.
Dopehead. I like Rich Swann just toning around there.
Oh. Nice drop kick.
That was a nice kick, I'll give it to him. Even though I don't want to. What do we got here?
Nice back suplex.
Shane Thorne, what's he going for here?
Ooh.
Oh.
Beautiful Phoenix splash.
Rich Swann getting a taste of his own medicine.
Kick out. Early kick out.
Oh, what a kick.
Oh.
Rich Swann's got to do something.
Oh. Neck breaker.
See, I know what Rich Swann's doing. He's letting Shane Thorne get this offense.
Ooh. Oh. I guess maybe he figures, Rich Swann figures, let Shane Thorne tire himself out, and then he can get in some offense.
That's pretty much what he's doing now. It's genius.
Ooh, nice elbow drop.
Pure genius.
It is a pretty good strategy. Oh. A nice spinning heel kick there, reversed into a DDT. And Rich Swann almost getting his feet hung up on the ropes there. Into the corner, and here comes Nick Miller.
Is this allowed?
One,
two, three, four, five. Okay, they're disqualified. Yeah.
That was awesome.
I don't want to admit it was awesome.
Oh! Big clothesline by Nick Miller.
Now,
in comes Cedric Alexander. Nick Miller on the top rope. Oh!
That caught him by surprise.
Nice kick to the gut. And what are we going to see here?
I'm about to see a beautiful move here.
I was thinking superplex, but then...
That makes me want to go to the
Cedric
chiropractor.
Cedric Alexander just dropping Nick Miller's back on his leg there.
That makes me want to go to the chiropractor.
Most of the things these men do in the ring make me want to go to the chiropractor.
Yeah.
Ooh, going for another forearm there. Yeah. Ooh, a nice running neck breaker. Fist drop
right there. You know, the Authors of Pain, they really want their rematch with TM61, and I can't blame them.
It's understandable. Ooh.
Oh!
Cedric Alexander able to move out of the way in that one.
Nice body slam.
Ooh, kick to the back of the head.
Loved it. Forearm in it.
Ooh.
Jumping in Siguri.
And, just almost adding insult to injury, just doing these moves right in front of his partner.
I don't mind it. I think it's funny.
Going for...
Clothesline. Nick Miller daring him to get up now.
What's he calling for? Ooh, rebound off the ropes. Oh. Ooh, looking for a chop. Clothesline.
Dopehead got caught up in the rope. That's what happened.
Or maybe he was trying to fake out Cedric Alexander in another neckbreaker.
I'm just taunting him. Yeah, he's a jerk, that's why.
Ooh.
Almost making a mistake there, throwing him into his own corner.
But a nice rebound hip toss by Nick Miller. Nick Miller going up to the top here.
And
a beautiful moonsault.
That's gotta hurt.
Cedric Alexander, not in good shape here, and in comes Shane Thorne. What are we going to see?
We're going to see a Hurricane Rana.
Beautiful Hurricane Rana.
Now he didn't see the tag.
In comes Rich Swann. Shane Thorne doesn't know a thing. And a beautiful swinging DDT.
That's going to hurt in the morning.
And Rich Swann with offense now, never mind a bulldog. To reverse the back suplex. And just like that, the flame has been extinguished from that hot tag. And another double team.
They're going for it again.
Ooh.
No. Oh,
can
yeah.
this move take out Rich Swann here? Rich Swann in a lot of pain.
Might be out of it. No. Kick out.
Late to kick out.
Now what's he going for?
Oh. Oh,
Rich Swann getting out of the way. Oh.
Oh. Ooh. Beautiful set of kicks.
Now, tossing him into the corner.
Well, some high energy double team of their own.
Yeah, well, you took the words right out of my mouth, you jerk.
Ooh.
Ah. Just, I'll have to go to a chiropractor twice.
Ooh.
Oh.
Beautiful kick from Cedric Alexander. Oh, I don't know what he was going for there.
That dope head.
Gonna try for it again. Nope.
Oh.
Nick Miller caught him.
Nice uppercut.
What's he going for? Oh, a spine buster. Ooh.
Oh. Is he allowed to do that?
Taking Rich Swann right off the apron.
That's gotta be illegal.
But it's not.
I think it is.
But it's not. What are they going for here?
Oh, this is gonna hurt.
Oh!
Rich Swann trying to get up on the outside.
He has no clue this pinfall is happening.
Two.
And just like that, TM61 showing why they're your SmackDown Tag Team Champions.
Yeah, by luck. Luck.
You know what,
Luck!
You come on here and you praise SmackDown every week, and you're talking trash on half their champions.
Technically, it's less than half.
Almost half their champions.
I have nothing against TM61. They're just the champions by luck.
I'd say that's talking trash.
I like these guys. Now imagine if I hated them.
I mean, what would you do if you hated them?
I would hate them.
No, that's crazy.
I'm just saying.
All right, well, I think it's time to move on to the next matchup here.
Yes, and what better way to go on to a next match than to go on to the Intercontinental Championship match?
Your Intercontinental Championship match starts right now. Alrighty, guys, getting in to your Intercontinental Championship matchup. We've got Hideo Itami taking on your Intercontinental Champion, Roderick Strong.
Right, Roderick Strong, that amazing triple threat match back at Payback, defeating Ty Dillinger and Sami Zayn. A lot of people are already saying that was match of the year.
And the, And I wouldn't argue up until this point that it has to be one of the best matches we've seen thus far. Roderick Strong. Strong out of the gate here. And Hideo Itami, smart to roll out of the ring.
Roderick chasing after him.
Fooling Hideo Itami.
Dopehead.
And Hideo Itami may have just done himself in.
Hideo Itami, the dopehead.
Catching Roderick Strong as he came off the apron there.
And...
German.
His head just bouncing off the apron like that. Shoving him right there. Hideo Itami, he has a lot to prove. Like I said, he didn't even get a chance to be in that tag team match last week, so he's got to make this count.
Hideo Itami sizing up Roderick Strong. Missing the clothesline.
Roderick didn't miss his, though.
Seven count. Strong doesn't want to defend the title by a count out, though. Fighting champion like he is.
I'll give it to him. He's doing it. It's pride. I'll give it to him.
A backbreaker to Hideo Itami.
You know what the fans could do for a fun drinking game? Take a shot every time Hideo Itami gets injured.
Well, I mean, I guess that would be something.
I'm just saying.
Here comes Strong off the second rope. Just out of the way. And a float over DDT by Itami. Double axe handle slam.
Now, going for another one.
German suplex.
Going to the top rope.
Hideo Itami up to the top rope. Calling for Roderick Strong to get up. I don't really know what that was. A fist drop, maybe.
Roderick Strong's in trouble here. I'm just tossing him.
A power slam.
Now Dale going for a pinfall here. One. No.
Kick out at one by Roderick Strong. That's not going to be nearly enough to put him away.
No. Strong wants to keep that title. I can't blame him.
Strong swinging for the fences there and missing.
Drop kick.
Beautiful drop kick.
And now.
Again.
He is not going to get that move.
Hideo Itami almost just smashing his head off of the announce desk. And if that would have happened, I think Tyler's little game would have came into play, to be honest with you.
My game?
The drinking game he came up with.
Oh, yeah. You're right.
Strong back in the ring. Hideo Itami.
He wants to win.
Who knows if he'll get up after that dive to the outside again in a suplex slam.
That is not pretty.
Hideo Itami, I think he's seeing stars at this point.
Not on the outside.
On the outside. Hideo Itami.
Now tossing him in the ring.
Now keep in mind, Hideo Itami has to remember, he begged, pleaded, demanded this match.
Yes, he did.
And now he's getting...
Now Roger going
he's
for
getting
a
what
pinfall.
He asked for here.
One. No.
Kick out at one by Hideo Itami.
Both of these men kicking out at one.
Hideo Itami not willing to give up his title shot just yet. And a kitchen sink.
Kitchen sink.
I do believe that's what the move is called.
Is it?
I don't know. Maybe.
Drinks you on my soda. I heard you say, I don't know. Oh.
Beautiful combination here by Hideo Itami. Kicks to the chest.
Oh.
And Hideo Itami.
Just taunting now.
What's he calling for? Begging Roderick Strong to get up now.
Oh no.
Ooh.
Oh.
Beautiful kick.
Kick to the back now.
Ooh. Bouncing his elbow off of the mat.
Roderick Strong is out of it right now.
Hideo Itami. Oh! Just driving his elbow into the ground.
Roderick Strong doing the smart thing, rolling out of the way. And he's going for another suplex.
Ooh. Beautiful move.
Now just jumping to the top.
Oh, what an connects elbow. With an elbow drop, a beautiful elbow drop.
Going for a pinfall here. One, two. Oh, and a kick out.
Kick out at two.
Roderick Strong is shocked right now.
And understandably so. Hit him with a just beautiful elbow drop. And what's he calling for here?
What is this? And belly to belly. Overhead belly to belly, really.
Beautiful maneuver. Bouncing him off the ropes.
Oh, little bump there.
Oh, we're going to see this
kick
again.
Oh.
Just a kick to the back of the knee. And
Roderick Strong
doesn't see Hideo Itami.
Oh, what a drop kick.
Beautiful missile drop kick. Oof. Picking up Strong here.
And
knee to the face. Ooh, drop kick.
Foot to the face.
Hideo Itami getting confident here. Maybe too confident, who knows? There it is. Elbow to the knee.
Roderick, what's he doing? Tossing him out.
Ooh! A kick to the face. Ooh, a missile drop kick.
Drop kick. Roderick is in trouble. They're picking him up again.
Ooh!
Roderick refusing to give up. Now tossing him. Oh, what is he doing?
What is Roderick Strong going to do here?
No, we only saw one before, but it was too much. No.
Superplex. From the top rope. Ooh.
Oh.
Just adding insult to injury there.
Oh.
Hideo Itami. Reversal.
And
this combination again from Hideo Itami.
Now,
kicks to the chest.
And
again.
What's he calling for?
What's Hideo Itami going for here?
It can't be. Oh, he's GTS time.
Go to sleep.
Go! One, two.
No! A kick out at two by your Intercontinental Champion. And you have to think, after a go to sleep, how can Roderick Strong kick out? And not only that, but how is Hideo Itami going to win this match?
That is a good question.
Now Hideo Itami, not happy.
What's he doing? And nice little jawbreaker. Oh, Roderick's going for it. Look at this replay.
Just driving both knees into the lower back of Itami. And this might be the beginning of the end.
He's going one, two, no!
Kick out by Hideo Itami. How in the world is Hideo Itami still in this matchup?
And oh,
well,
Roddy's going for the.
Oh no, dude.
Oh, that hurts my back. That has gotta be it. One.
Both of these men are spent.
Ooh.
And Roderick Strong defending his Intercontinental Championship successfully.
That was crazy.
I don't know. I think that might be in contendership for Match of the Year now, too.
It's up to any match that Roderick Strong is in.
There seems to be a running theme there.
You know, years ago, Booker T on commentary say, oh, he's in my Fave 5, my top 5. Roderick Strong may be in my top 5.
Absolutely. Now, he's a great superstar to watch.
What do we got in here? Being given the Intercontinental Championship, his Intercontinental Championship.
And he earned the right to keep that belt tonight.
Well-deserved.
Well-deserved, hard-fought victory there. That was insane. And that was only our second matchup.
You know, honestly, if we were to say, okay, this is the end of the show, you're only getting 2 matches, everybody would get their money's worth.
Yeah, that's true.
Honestly, I don't even think we needed the first match. This alone, this should have main evented. This should have main evented.
Well, I mean, you could talk to the SmackDown general manager about that.
Trial and error.
Well, as awesome as this match was,
I want to see it again.
I think we have to move on to our next match, though.
I know we have
unfortunately.
To. Unfortunately. I want to see it again. It was too good.
Well, I mean, we got to move on.
All right, we can.
All right. Moving on to the next match. Alrighty, guys, getting into the matchup here. We've got Darren Young taking on Tyson Kidd and trying to take Darren Young out at the base.
Oh! Tyson Kidd being very aggressive here. He's going the Curtis Axel route.
Tyson Kidd just.
Ooh. Oh!
Super Kidd, aggressive.
Oh, another bump. That shit never. Now going for it again.
Oh, there we go.
Overhead belly to belly. Darren Young just rolling out.
Smart move here, but also leaving himself exposed. Oh! Being sent right to the outside.
Tyson Kidd, he's trying to send a message here.
I think that message is pain.
Clearly.
Into the steel steps.
Oh, what's he doing?
Darren Young doesn't expect a thing. Too busy favoring his head.
Oh, no.
Oh, what's he going for here? Oh! Tyson Kidd overjumped. That might have hurt himself. Maybe not. Popping right back up.
That hurt my ass.
Yeah, that hurt me just looking at it. I need to go to the chiropractor like 6 times.
Our kid just dragging him.
Dragging him back to the ring. And tossing Darren Young.
Ooh. Oh. Nice little flip.
Tyson Kidd might be tiring himself out here. He's been going so aggressive.
Oh. Darren Young. Oh.
Darren Young looking to return the favor. A drop kick to the knees.
He's getting into it now.
A nice float over neck breaker.
Oh, a little kick. Nice little jab.
What are we seeing here? Nice suplex.
We're seeing a suplex. That's what we're seeing. Oh. Oh. All these moves to the back. It's hurting me.
Oh.
Oh, there we go. Now, kid going to the top rope.
Beautiful moonsault. Back up to the top again and an elbow drop. Not gonna lie, I was expecting another moonsault. But it's fine, it's fine. Who am I to judge, you know?
Ooh, nobody.
An aggressive DDT.
Nobody judges.
Chef doesn't judge.
Well, Chef's dead, so.
It depends on what Chef you're talking about.
I'm thinking Chef from South Park.
Oh, well, maybe that's not the one I'm talking about.
Oh. Ooh. Tyson Kidd is rolling out.
Tyson Kidd, very smart.
Now.
Ooh.
Axe handle smash.
I don't think Tyson Kidd was expecting that one.
And
no, float over neck breaker on the outside. So many chiropractor visits, so little time.
Oh, yeah.
And, oh.
Oh.
I think we were going to see a DDT on the outside there, but
I don't think so.
Tyson Kidd very smart to get out of that. Tyson Kidd.
Oh.
A nice forearm smash there.
Now.
Ooh. Oh. Right in the back, right on the spine of Darren Young.
That has gotta hurt.
And Tyson Kidd.
And.
Ooh.
Oh. Look at this. Look at that.
I don't know what Tyson Kidd calls it, but it's beautiful.
It's painful.
Let's call it.
Let's call it a 1, a 2, and a 3. Yes.
Let's make up a name for it.
What do you want to call it?
It has to be something to do with Canada. So, like, I don't know. Like the.
How about A move? You know, like Canadians, they're like, eh, move.
I don't know if we should use any racial stereotypes.
I'm just saying.
I think it should be like, I don't know. Is there a move called like the Canadian Driver or something?
I don't know. We're going to figure it out.
I know there's a move called the Canadian Destroyer.
That's wrong company.
So?
Anyway. Yeah, folks, you know, putting on it was a decent match. It was, and what is? What's going on? Tyson Kidd's demanding a mic right now. What's he gonna say?
Let's see what Tyson Kidd has to say. Alrighty, guys, getting into the matchup here, we've got Curtis Axel taking on Goldust. And before this match, we saw Tyson Kidd demanding a shot at the Intercontinental Champion at Bad Blood. And Tyler, I think we're going to see that match at Bad Blood.
Oh, it'll happen.
Oh! Curtis Axel, not even waiting for Goldust to fully get up.
Hurting himself.
Curtis Axel taking the notion that our superstars put their bodies on the line to a new level.
Oh. He's putting his opponent's bodies on the line, if anything.
He's putting his own on the line, too, with that elbow drop.
And,
ooh, neck breaker, just bending Goldust in half.
Just throwing him into the corner again.
Just throwing him around this ring like a rag doll.
Not another top rope move.
Curtis Axel looks like he's going for a superplex from the top rope.
Now look at that, just taunting the crowd.
Goldust struggling to get to his feet. Oh, just a kick to the gut. Just insult to injury. Ooh, a big boot.
What sparked this new demeanor of Curtis Axel?
I don't know.
Does he even know?
I don't know.
Oh.
Is there something mentally wrong with Curtis Axel? I don't know.
He just
elbow drop.
Something just broke him, I guess.
The straw that broke the camel's back, as some might say. And will we ever figure out what that is? I don't know.
Curtis Axel, you know, he's a former tag team champion, he's a former Intercontinental champion, but there are a lot of people that say he's still living in the shadow of his father, Mr. Perfect. Maybe he just got tired of it? He just wants to break through that glass ceiling?
Ooh! And I guess we'll never know until Curtis Axel downright says it. But... Oh. Goldust looking for some kind of offense here.
Goldust coming back now.
Vintage Goldust there. The drop down throat thrust and a float over neck breaker.
You know, Ty Dillinger started to get offense last week and look what happened.
Well, it's seems to be the tail of the tape.
Now Goldust.
Goldust.
Throwing him into the corner.
Trying to get some offense in.
Oh. Working on that arm now.
Goldust looking for some high-octane offense of his own. Ooh. Oh. Reversal. No! Just bending the neck of Goldust and snapping it back.
Bending his whole body. Now Curtis Axel, what's he doing?
Ooh.
Curtis Axel just showing no mercy here.
Goldust can barely get up.
That's the move that took out Randy Orton.
That's the move that took out a whole lot of people.
Everybody.
Oh!
Goldust showing some heart here.
Goldust with some resiliency.
Now, another splash.
Curtis Axel, not happy.
He doesn't know what to do. Oh, no. We saw what happened last week when he grabbed the weapon against Ty Dillinger. No. All right, he put it down.
Goldust still can't get up.
Oof. And,
suplex.
Curtis Axel. Why don't you get in the ring with Curtis Axel?
That's a hard pass. Oof.
I'm just saying, I think you have a chance.
I'd say probably not, to be honest. Just driving the back of Gold Dust into the floor here.
And
again, the sidewalk slam.
This axe looks like he's done with him. Axel is taunting now.
And Gold Dust trying with all of his might to get back to the ring before the count of 10.
Axel just waiting for him. Oh, Axel doesn't see Gold Dust.
Oh! Go! Gold Dust pulling him down in a nice crucifix.
He's finally getting into it now.
Gold Dust trying to get back in this matchup any way that he can in a Russian leg sweep. Off the ropes. So a nice clothesline.
Has anybody checked on Ty Dillinger since last week? I gotta ask.
I mean, I think our medical staff was supposed to.
I hope they did.
I mean, if not, then he might just be like laying somewhere in the arena we were in last week.
That would be bad.
That would not be good. Oof.
Curtis Axel.
That'd give WWE PR a bad rap.
And oh!
Curtis Axel. Just decimating Gold Dust.
Now what's he doing here?
Oh, he's going for it.
The perfect plex.
Ooh.
No, the perfect plex.
Shades of his dad right there.
Two.
Curtis Axel. Just absolute decimation.
Gold Dust. He tried.
I mean, he showed some valiancy with that kick out, but it just wasn't enough.
I don't know what to say. At least that was not as bad of a beating as last week.
I mean, I guess that's true, but oh, jeez.
Oh,
here comes Orton. Oh! Curtis Axel didn't see him. And Randy Orton, of course, these two have been going back and forth the past couple of weeks. And oh, DDT.
Thought Randy Orton was out.
We thought Randy Orton was out. But he's back. And I think he's got something for Axel.
And, oh my God. What is this?
Oh! A sadistic neck breaker in the Orton stomp. We're going around the park.
Somebody is finally getting the upper hand on Curtis Axel.
Oh! Orton playing Axel his own game. Orton taking out Axel.
It took how long for somebody to finally get the upper hand on Curtis Axel?
And who other than Randy Orton to use the same underhanded tactics that Curtis Axel uses?
Genius.
The veteran in Orton showing his smarts tonight.
Oh, definitely.
And with that, I think we need to move on to our next matchup.
We should. Otherwise, because I really don't want to see Curtis Axel wake up right now knowing what just happened.
That's probably not a sight that's you know, PG for the kids, you know?
Pretty much.
So let's just avoid all that and move on to the next match.
You remember one, and this box of fireworks.
Alrighty, guys, getting into the matchup here, we've got Ember Moon taking on Tamina.
Oh.
A headbutt by Ember Moon and a headbutt back.
Oh, nice little punch there.
Oh, an even bigger headbutt by Tamina.
It was back and forth.
Ooh, just insult to injury, just pushing her down.
Ember Moon, she has a lot to prove.
Ooh, Tamina going for another headbutt, and Ember saying, nuh-uh. Ooh, a forearm.
Now what you going for?
Ooh, a splash.
No. Going for a pinfall early. Rope break.
Rope break.
Ooh.
Ooh, a fall-away slam.
That's gotta hurt.
Just tossing Tamina halfway across the ring. The strength of Ember Moon.
Now, you gotta think, if it was not for the iconic duo of Billie Kay and Peyton Royce, would Ember Moon be the SmackDown Women's Champion right now?
And, I mean, it has to cross your mind at least once that that could have been the outcome of that matchup.
You can't help but think it.
And Ember Moon, understandably, probably not happy about what happened to her. Ooh, a big boot by Tamina.
Would you be happy if it happened to you?
I mean, probably not.
Exactly.
What's Tamina going for here? Ooh, a big strike.
Nice little uppercut there.
Ooh,
DDT.
DDT. Ember Moon smart to roll out of the ring here. Tamina just taunting her.
Ember Moon getting back in the ring.
Ooh.
Beating her to the punch, literally. Another pinfall. One.
Another kick out by Tamina. Ember Moon keeps trying to end this match quick.
If she wants to get another shot at that championship quick.
I mean, it's understandable. Tamina might have hurt her back there, favoring that lower back of hers.
And elbow drop.
Elbow drop to Tamina's chest.
Ember Moon. And
neckbreaker.
How many times are we going to go to the chiropractor after all these matches?
A lot.
I'm just saying.
A lot. Into the corner goes Tamina. Ember Moon.
Knees right to the chest.
That's gotta hurt.
Go
Ember
in
Moon.
Find out.
Another one. Another tiger suplex. I believe that's what that's called. It's probably wrong, though.
Who knows? I'm sure somebody knows.
Ooh.
Another pinfall.
Another pinfall.
Two. No.
And a kick out by Tamina. This one at two. And a kick to the back.
And no.
Ooh.
Reverse. Nice little fireman's carry there.
Luthez.
Jinx, you owe me a soda. How many sodas do you owe me?
I don't know, dude.
You owe me an entire... You owe me a lifetime supply of Baja Blast.
I think that's false. I don't even think it's up to a 12-pack yet.
It pretty much is now.
I don't know.
I want everybody to go back in the past episodes and count how many times he owes me a soda.
I would guess like 9 to 10. Oh!
And
beautiful back suplex by Ember Moon to turn the tides of the match. Match very back and forth so far.
Oh!
Beautiful set of kicks. Tyler, could you do that?
I could. I just, don't feel like it.
I get it. You're not stretched or anything. I get it.
Exactly. It's a lot of hard work.
Understandable.
Oh.
Ooh. And a Russian leg sweep.
And the Moon getting psyched up now. And just tossing Tamina.
What's Ember Moon gonna do here? The crazy athleticism by Ember Moon. Now she's going up to the top rope.
Go Would this be it? Total Eclipse. And... Look at this. Look at that.
Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. And Tamina is out like a light. That just dragging her lifeless body across the ring.
Can this be the final pinfall? One, two, yes.
And just like that, Ember Moon with the total eclipse ending this matchup with Tamina.
Getting one step closer to getting her hands on that SmackDown Women's Championship.
And, gosh, Ember Moon, beautiful athleticism throughout this matchup.
Incredible.
Just, it's insane. The way she's able to just throw Tamina around like that, and as you see, like a handspring clothesline, and then the total eclipse. It's great.
It's breathtaking.
It is.
She wants that title shot.
And understandably so, after being, what some would say, screwed out of it.
Oh, yeah.
And... we'll have to see within the next couple of weeks what happens leading up to Bad Blood. But you have to think, Ember Moon has to be one of the top contenders, if not the number one contender, for the Women's Championship.
I think she's done enough to prove that she is.
And, yeah, I don't know.
You know what I know?
She's number one contender in my book.
You know what I know?
What's that?
Since you said one, we have one more match.
That's true. You're not wrong.
I'm always right. We've been through this, you dope head.
There's proof of you being wrong, though, dude.
It's fake.
It's not fake,
it's
dude.
It's fake.
It's not fake.
I was saying what I meant to say the wrong answer.
Oh, okay.
Because I didn't want to be a show-off and be right all the time. So, ha.
That's not what you said in the moment, though.
Shut up.
If I remember correctly, you said something along the lines of...
I remember there's a main event. I'm explaining to you we have a main event.
Yeah?
That we need to get to.
Okay.
We don't have time for your gibberish.
We don't have time for my jibber jabber?
Yes. So, we gotta get to that main event.
I guess you're right. Alrighty, guys. We're at the main event. Dean Ambrose and Seth Rollins taking on Baron Corbin, your WWE champion,
and Chris
Jericho. Oh.
I predicted him winning the WWE title, keep in mind.
There might be something else you want to keep in mind about that night, too, is that that's the only prediction you got right that night.
The damn psychic hotline lied to me.
I mean, I can't control that, Tyler, you know what I mean?
I wish you could. Oh.
Well, what makes you think my predictions would have been right?
Shut up.
Just tossing Seth Rollins to the ground.
Baron Corbin, business here. And I'm surprised he's here after last week when Dean Ambrose did that sneak attack, hitting those three dirty deeds on him.
Baron Corbin, a fighting champ. Gotta
going for a
hand that to him. Jericho looking for an early pinfall.
No.
Kick out of one by Rollins.
Oh.
Ooh, Rollins just springing up, doesn't know where he is now. Ooh.
Chris Jericho. Oh.
Oh. Well, Chris Jericho. Or Seth Rollins looking to take out Chris Jericho's knees there, maybe, but he's
punching him.
Completely missed.
Oh. Oh.
Drop kick by Rollins.
No.
Ooh.
Now what's he going for here?
Ooh. Oh.
Frog splash.
Beautiful frog splash by Seth Rollins. And into the corner goes Jericho.
Two-thirds of the Shield out here right now teaming up.
And here we see some double team action.
Yeah, I think Dean Ambrose, he wants to get his hands on Baron Corbin, but I think he's really happy right now getting his hands on Chris Jericho after Jericho murdered Mitch the Plant.
Ooh. And, you gotta think that Ambrose has some resentment there.
Dirty deeds.
And the dirty deeds right off the start.
Oh, Ambrose. Ooh. He doesn't want to end it there.
Ambrose,
he wants his hands on Baron Corbin.
Isn't done.
He wants his hands on Baron Corbin.
And I'm surprised Chris Jericho can even move.
Oof. Now Jericho. Oh.
Kick to the back of the knee. Oh. And a beautiful enziguri.
And Baron Corbin getting in. Oh. Dean Ambrose and Seth Rollins. They could have had the match won right then and there, but no.
They could have, but this is what Ambrose wanted. He wanted to be in the ring with Baron Corbin.
I don't think this is exactly how he wanted it to go, though.
True! Oh. And a big back body drop. And Ambrose probably has no clue where he's at.
Baron Corbin just being dominant here. Oh!
Ambrose.
Oh, that's got to be a disqualification there.
Ambrose going up to the top rope. Ooh, an elbow drop.
And, oh.
Beautiful clothesline.
Dean Ambrose, he wants his revenge.
Took his eyes off Corbin for just a second.
Now Corbin going to the top.
And can Corbin make it all the way across the ring like that? And yes, he can. The big man Corbin showing he's got hops too.
That's gotta hurt.
Into the corner goes Ambrose.
Now going for another double team. Here we go again.
Ooh. Nice assisted suplex there. And Jericho taunting the crowd, of course.
Jericho, he didn't see the hot tag.
And here comes Rollins. Oh, running right into the elbow of Jericho, though.
That was a fail.
So much for a hot tag. And into the corner goes Rollins now.
Oh.
Ooh, a back elbow. Maybe the flame has been reignited. We'll see. Ooh.
Rollins is going to burn it down.
Of course. Off of a hot tag, he would.
Ah.
Oh.
Yeah, you dope head.
He got it the second time, though, which is okay, which is fine. It's 100% okay.
Ooh. Oh. Now Jericho.
The float over a neck breaker. And Rollins planted on the ground.
Now what's he doing?
And the lion's salt.
That's gotta hurt. Jericho just tossing him.
What are we going to see here? Oh!
Oh, we've seen this how many times?
Oh! Triangle drop kick.
Tag to Corbin.
And Rollins can't get up, being drop kicked to the outside.
Oh!
Just a devastating kick.
Oh, not again.
Oh! Just... Oof.
Saw that before.
That punch just adding insult to injury. Oh, on the outside.
That cannot feel good.
Rollins has got to be in trouble at this point. And then just targeting that back of Rollins.
Now Seth reversing.
And, oh.
Corbin doing the smart thing by rolling in.
And, oh, just tossing Rollins back into the ring. Okay. Rollins.
Jericho back in now.
No way he's getting Ambrose. Right now! Beautiful drop kick.
Jericho went down fast.
Chris Jericho struggling to get up here.
What's he doing? And...
Oh! There's no way Rollins could have seen that coming. A catching, Codebreaker catching Rollins off the rope, and down goes Ambrose. And what are we going to see here?
End of days.
And just Ambrose like that, I think our main event is over. Oof. Corbin and Jericho.
Ouch.
The dynamic duo.
End of days. I mean, that's destructive and all, but I think the move of that match was without a doubt that Codebreaker.
And you see it right here, just Rollins just going for a splash, I guess, and just
end of days right there.
Jericho, the veteran, just took advantage of
the goat
of Rollins' carelessness. And let me tell you, Rollins paid for it. Because not only did he take that Codebreaker, but right after, an end of days.
Dean Ambrose couldn't even make the save. He got took down right before the end of days.
And Ambrose didn't see it coming. And just like that, this pretty destructive duo of Chris Jericho and Baron Corbin.
Could be potential there.
There could be potential there. That was an awesome match, though.
It was, but...
It was an awesome show altogether.
That Codebreaker, though.
That Codebreaker, though. You're not wrong.
Tonight was... It was crazy. I mean, this... That incredible catching Codebreaker. The phenomenal Intercontinental Championship match we had. SmackDown. A show, baby.
And, I don't know. Tonight was definitely crazy. We saw the Intercontinental Championship be defended.
Amazing match.
Absolutely amazing match. Roderick Strong putting on quite a show for us here tonight. But guys, it is unfortunately the end of SmackDown. But we'll be live on the WWE Network this Sunday for Unforgiven, the Raw pay-per-view for this month. And we'll see what Raw has in store.
Nothing. Because it's not SmackDown, baby. SmackDown's where it's at.
Okay. Well, be sure to tune into the pay-per-view on Sunday. Thank you guys so much for watching. And good night.